Swindon Church's Action for Justice claims a pedigree stretching back approximately 30 years, with a couple of name changes over that time. Under the financial umbrella and endorsement of Swindon Churches Together, the group has welcomed into its membership any individual with an interest in promoting the church's agenda of social and economic justice locally, nationally, and on a wider map. There are currently 9 people on our mailing list, and meetings attract about half a dozen. The last meeting of the group in January focused its attention on the ongoing discussion and activity to do with the future of its sponsors, Swindon Churches Together, and the last and next issues of the Grapevine magazine, which we have published biannually during most years since our inception. The latest issue is number 62, and it should have appeared by now in your church. About 2,000 copies are printed for distribution to all the churches that Swindon Churches Together represents, and to some other bodies in the borough. Our last two issues have prompted favourable reviews from some individuals, and one substantial donation towards production costs. In the latest edition, we covered matters concerning how we use or misuse the Bible to support our own ideas about religious, social and political ideas, with other articles on inequality in Swindon and featuring the work of Booth House, the Salvation Army Hostel and Social Enterprise for Homeless Men in Swindon, and the work of End Hunger UK. I hope you have seen and been able to read a copy from your local church. The next Grapevine is planned for early summer. With a reduced membership and some uncertainty over the future course of Swindon Churches Together, other activities such as national election hustings, the last was organised by Swindon Churches Together, our annual meal with our MPs and council leaders to discuss issues of social, political and ethical concern locally and beyond, and public meetings around such contemporary matters have been suspended. Our active remit at one time was broader than at present, but we continue and hope to widen our activity again at some point in the future. If you are interested in our agenda, albeit currently narrower than in the past, do get in touch with me, Tony Barnes, through Swindon Churches Together using the contact details on this website.